In Amsterdam, I dreamt I saw my mother again. She was just as glad to see me as I was to see her. Same beautiful pale blue eyes. Everything would have turned out better if she had lived. As it was, she died when I was a kid. And when I lost her, I lost sight of any landmark that might have led me someplace happier. You see, her death was my fault. Everybody used to tell me that it wasn't. That it was a terrible accident. Which is all perfectly true. And I don't believe a word of it. It was my fault. Just like everything that's happened since. The painting. The painting. All my fault. I lost something that should have been immortal. I didn't mean to do it. Because what I've done cannot be undone. It doesn't matter that I'm going to die. But for all time, for as long as history is written, that painting will be remembered and mourned.
As best we can tell, he made his own way back to his mother's apartment from the museum. He waited there for her all night to come back, and when she didn't, he rang the emergency number they were showing on TV. When they realized his age, they alerted us.
I don't know if you're aware, but Theo's father left the family about 6 months ago.
I wasn't aware. My son and Theo were friends in elementary school. To my knowledge, they haven't seen much of each other for a while. I'm afraid I don't quite understand.
Right now, he is a minor child in need of temporary emergency care. When we asked Theo if he could think of anyone that might be able to help for a while, he suggested you.
Come in, come in.
I'm afraid Andy isn't up yet. You can rest here if you like.
Let's get you squared away. Oh, here we are. You'll be feeling awfully rough. Hell of a thing to happen. Good Lord. In the circumstances, I wouldn't see the harm in pouring you what my father used to call a minor nip, if you should want
some.
Which, of course, you don't. Quite unsuitable.
We're perfectly happy to have you, Theo. I hope you'll make yourself as comfortable as you can.
What's happening?
Best view is not best. Someone to see you, Theo.
Wow. Disturbing.
Yeah.
No. Apparently no one has any idea where he is. He wasn't paying child support. He left debts. He more or less flew town without a word. I don't think we had a choice. We couldn't very well turn the boy away. No, just for a few weeks.
Do you sail, Theo?
No, sir.
That's a pity. Andy had the most outstanding time at his sailing camp up in Maine last year.
They were the worst 2 weeks of my life.
Nonsense. You lack confidence, that's all.
Would you like me to ask Etta to make you something else to eat, Theo?
I'm not hungry. Thank you.
Where's his dad?
Good question.
Oh my God.
Try this on, Theo. It's an old one of Platt's. It's so cold outside.
Outside?
I think you should go back to school next week. The sooner we get back to a normal routine, the better. Keeping busy is the only thing for it. Perhaps you could go this afternoon. To your apartment. I could come with you.
I meant to clean up while I was waiting for her.
You get what you need. I'll tidy this up. Just your school things, the rest can wait.
My mom was bringing me in to see the principal about the cigarettes.
Yeah, my mom blew up over that shit too. So, I gotta go. Later.
Creepy-o.
I'm going to go swimming every day.
You can't swim by yourself. You're not allowed.
Everyone's going to swim. The cure for anything is salt water. Greatest gift my father ever gave me was the sea, the love for it, the feel.
What's he going to do while we're away?
Who's the artist I like, Samantha, with the grand skies?